As the gold standard in Synergy application development, Workbench offers an incredible array of customizable tools to make development faster and more efficient. Like any Windows-based IDE, Workbench incorporates a toolbar for quick access to common functions. But Workbench also allows developers to customize the toolbar buttons that are made available, thus defining one-click operations specific to the tasks they're most likely to perform. In this webucation, we'll discuss the addition of a few extra buttons that can streamline compile time tasks, as well as making a commonly used tool instantly accessible. Here we see the default configuration of the toolbar as it is when you first launch Workbench. One of the first things you can do is to clean up some real estate for reuse with more helpful tools. The current context box is here by default. Its purpose is to tell you where, in your code, your cursor is positioned, or gives you a drop-down list to allow you to quickly jump to another section. Since we usually know where we are in our code, or can get somewhere else quickly with other tools, this space might be better used for something we'll do more often. Let's remove current context from the toolbar. Right-click in an open area of the toolbar, scroll down the list to current context, and uncheck it. That's much better, but now these buttons are left dangling by themselves. While we'll want to keep the buttons, they give you quick access to the repository, the online manuals, and other Synergy tools, we can reclaim the space from the row they're occupying. By dragging the two vertical bars to the left of the buttons, we can move them up all at once and place them where current context used to be. There are a couple of extremely useful buttons we can also add. These are the project tools, so let's right-click the toolbar again, scroll down toward the bottom, and select them. Now, this is an undocked window, and we don't want it floating around, so let's move it up and dock it in the toolbar. What we've just added is a suite of tools to build and compile our code, along with quick buttons to check in or check out the source code if we happen to be using version control. This button simply moves the cursor from one error to the next if your compile fails. Since Synergy developers rarely have errors in their code, and you may find this button unnecessary, particularly when you can just double-click the error message in the build window below, let's remove it. But how do we remove single buttons? Right-click the toolbar again and click Customize. Now we can start removing or adding individual buttons to suit our needs. First, drag the error jumper off of the toolbar. Next, we see that the build and compile buttons are actually in a non-intuitive order. Let's make sure compile comes first, so simply drag it in front of the build button. Since you may find it's useful to have a run and debug button as well, let's add those next. In the toolbar customization window, select categories, then scroll down to project. Here, we've got a lot of different buttons to choose from, some of which have already been added. But find the Run button, hovering over each button will tell us its function, and drag it to the toolbar just after the Build button. Likewise, find and then drag the Debug button up onto the toolbar. We're almost finished, but let's add just one more function. You may find that quick access to the command prompt is helpful. Find the miscellaneous entry in your category list and click it. The fourth icon should look like a little window with a command prompt. Drag it up to your toolbar and place it after the project tools. It might also be nice to separate it from the other commands, so select space in the category list and drag one up into your toolbar. As you can see, there are literally hundreds of buttons and functions which can be added to your toolbar. Take some time to review them, and you'll probably find something else you just can't live without. Be sure to check out the other Workbench webucations for more information on customizing and configuring Workbench.